For more than a decade, the WWE Universe has embraced the coexistence of two major titles, both steeped in history and tradition. The World Heavyweight Championship and the WWE Championship. But following SummerSlam 2014, the two prestigious titles were combined into one top honor. So, what would the new WWE World Heavyweight Championship look like? In creating the new title, WWE would borrow inspiration from past designs.
The redesign of the title was first explored probably 5 years ago when we sort of took a look at the spinner title. What we really liked was this WWE logo that was incorporated into it. It was identifiable, it looked great in stadiums and arenas, looked great on television.
We wanted to engineer something that just had never been done before. We came up with a title that had the contrast of the leather and the metal, and doing these cutouts and really playing up the WWE logo.
In February of 2013, The Rock debuted that re-envisioned championship. But only 1 year later, WWE changed everything by launching WWE Network. Now, the logo that had been previously unveiled for the network would come to represent the entire company.
The new logo, it was just so good and represented who we really are, not just with our network. This looks like who we really are now.
Our product has evolved, has changed, has grown, and it's time to reflect that in our branding.
Of course, the corporate rebranding meant that, among other things, the design of the championship would have to evolve as well.
We went through various design directions to try to come up with a new title to outdo the last one we just did. And really came down to there's nothing going to be more iconic than continuing that shape, but really just refining it with the new logo.
To bring the new design to life, WWE turned to an unlikely partner.
Orange County Choppers started in 1999. We build custom bikes. We do a lot of theme bikes for corporations. That's what we're known for.
We established a relationship with Orange County Choppers back in 2008 when they customized a motorcycle for us in promotion of WrestleMania.
One of the things that was cool on that bike is we did a replica belt on the primary cover, which was made to look like the championship.
Orange County Choppers had gone from building that replica to fabricating the actual WWE Championship in 2012. And in the spring of 2014, they began to manufacture the new WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
You would think in theory that a championship belt and a motorcycle are completely different, but when you get right down to it, you're cutting metal into certain shapes with the detail work that Orange County Choppers is really known for.
Creative Services at WWE came up with the design for this belt. They sent us a key here that shows the overall size and shape of the different plates that they want. From their PDF, we can convert that to arcs and lines. We then have to take that and create this artwork in metal. We're machining this out of basically a solid aluminum block. We'll actually use our water jet machine here to take that initial plate and cut through and make all those individual cuts.
When we saw the way they were fabricating this title belt, it looked like something out of a science fiction movie. To see the precision with which it was done was just fascinating.
The title belt that we're working on has somewhere around 267 individual stones. You can see this graphic representation here of the size of the tool that we have going in there and cutting the pockets that each of those stones will sit in. We're putting jewels in the same way a dentist would put a filling in your tooth.
The white cardboard is pretty much where all the holes are going to be, the plates. There's a lot of beveled lines that are tooled into it. Next to it, you have the actual cutout of the belt. We're going to punch the holes for where the snaps are going to go. We're gonna bevel the edges of it, and we're gonna stamp the WWE logo into it.
one of the big things with the championship belt here is that it's contoured to fit the individual. It's not just a bunch of flat plates.
What we're going to do is we're going to anneal the aluminum just to put into a soft state so we can roll it into the shape just for the belt. I'll heat it up real nice and then put a acetylene over it. And I burn that off. It gets it to the right temperature.
Each of the different components have to be rolled to a precise radius. After I put it through the roll, which actually stretches the metal around three round discs there, you can see, puts a nice curvature to it, exactly the shape it needs to be.
I used a oil-based black dye. The dyeing is actually fairly quick. You use two coats, and then you buff it out. Slicking the edges takes some time.
When it comes to inlaying precious stones and things in there, all kind of things that we've done in the past on a motorcycle, and now we're just applying it to a belt.
With the finishing touches being applied, the WWE Universe was ready for the unveiling.
The name Orange County Choppers stands for perfection. We have a high standard on everything that we do. We take pride in it.
And the finished belt that goes out of here is looked over and inspected as closely as one of our bikes.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the brand new WWE World Heavyweight title.
The new logo, how symmetrical and rigid it is. It really lent itself to the new title belt design really well. It's solid, symmetrical, it's almost mathematical.
But this championship belt represents some of the older designs. Surely the W representing WWE. You should keep the tradition and add to that. It's a combination of new and old, and it should be.